Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the concept of a human aspect of a project management. So basically, humans are the one who will be doing the projects and all those things, right? Yes. So their interaction, their meetings, their coordination, everything plays an important role with the help of the project, guys. Okay. So for a successful execution of a project, a satisfactory human relation is a must. Without such a system, other systems of a project management do not work properly. So to achieve satisfactory human relation in a project setting, the project manager must successfully handle few problems or few challenges. Okay. So basically these are the steps which should be taken by the project manager, in simple words you can say, guys. Okay. Yes. So basically he is the one who will be assigning the things, he will be the one who will be taking the in charge of the whole project, right? Yes. Hence he should take care of the whole interactions between the people, the humans, the members who are working and everything, right? Yes. So the first thing is nothing but the authority. So whenever the project manager says something, everyone should follow it. It is like a command to everyone. Okay. So in project management, the project manager whose activities cut across a functional line of commands lack the desired formal authority. Okay. So while the manager has a formal control, okay, so basically here it is all explaining about the authority, guys. So basically whenever the project manager orders or says someone to do something, they should start working on it and they need to complete it. Only then we can say that the interaction between the manager and the colleagues is really good, right? So in that we can say, okay. Similarly, the next way is nothing but orientation. So most of the managers work for a project are engineers or technologists. When an engineer assumes the managerial responsibility, he faces some difficult type of problems which he is supposed to perform the task or planning, organizing and all those things. So basically the project managers will have the idea of the project, right? So the project manager is the one who is communicating with the client very frequently. So he should have the knowledge of the project and how it works and all the thing, right? But so this leads to a drawback that he might not be good at financing and all those things, right? So any other aspects other than the project idea and all those things. So that is one more kind of issue. Similarly, motivation. So the one who is the project leader or the team leader, you can say, he is the one who should give motivation for the whole group, guys. Okay. Yes. So whenever you get motivation, you are influenced to do works, guys. So whenever you are having some kind of exam, you will be going to YouTube and seeing some motivational videos, right? So in that, the same way that when you are doing a project, when something goes in the correct way or the wrong way, you need some motivation. It's okay. There is no issue. Let us try it again. So in that way, you need some motivation. Only then you can do it, right? Yes. Similarly, group functionality. So basically, when you are working in a company, your project will be taken by a group, guys. You are not going to do it solely. That is the reason why the group interactions, the group things should be in a proper way and systematic way, right? Yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about this. So if it is asked for an LAQ, you can write some examples and you can expand the answer, guys. Okay. Yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea. So in the next lecture, we'll be discussing about the tax burden and tax holiday. Okay. Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.